Media.
I think that people portray themselves as something they're not most of the time because they feel like they have something to prove or whatever. They say if they're bald, they put themselves with real hair, or they make it really superficial, like girls will try to show more skin and their profile pictures or something like that, just to get attraction or get followers or something like that. It's kind of superficial to me.
As far as portraying yourself on social media, I mean that everybody creates a different personality. Not really a different personality, but you try to make yourself seem, I don't know, like more better than your, like that's the point of filters. So you know, you
put your best,
You put your best out, you know, so they'll like you to come in that way.
On social media, like they'll put alcohol and drugs and party scene all the time, and sometimes girls are like half naked for likes and stuff like that. So it can be portrayed both in a positive and negative light. It depends on the person you are and how you handle your personal life.
I personally think that most people use Instagram as a way of expressing things that are important to them. I feel that it's a type of social media that can be used to show things that have a significant meaning to you. Like inside jokes between you and your friends, or something that you found funny too.
Social media can either ruin you or it can benefit you in many ways. Like, for example, on social media, what I tend to do is show my accomplishments. So I can not only boast about all the good things that I've done, but I can also motivate others to do the same. But a lot of people also.
It depends on the person.
Yeah, it does depend on it depends on the person and how they go about, like, because some people like just post like naked pictures all day, and other people are Instagram, for instance, can be used for business, like hairstylists all on Instagram,
like radio
promoting, like Instagram, it goes for, it depends on the person really, so it can be positive and negative.
We usually see people that post drugs and alcohol and like party attire all the time on their Instagram, Facebook, and stuff like that. I typically think that they just are a party animal, like they don't really want to do anything else with their life, and they're just worried about the fun part of life. They're not really worried about pushing themselves to do better and benefiting themselves in the long run. So usually those negative portrayals to me just seem like they're not trying to be anything in life. They're just trying to be the center of attention all the time. So that's usually what I think of the negative portrayals on social media.
Well, they feel good about themselves. The more likes you get, I mean, the struggle it is to get 100 likes. It's really a struggle. No, seriously, it's a struggle. Because you have to follow the right amount of people. And then if you follow the right amount of people and you like their pictures, they do like for a like. Like, people really struggle for likes.
It just means you popping. If you ain't break the 100, yeah.
It just means the likes.
Yeah.
I mean,
they mean a lot. If you cannot get past the base case.
No, sometimes likes don't mean a lot because some people just get likes because they're liked as a person, but their pictures be weak and they still get likes because true. Like likes don't really mean, likes are just.
They are
when you see the notification on your phone, like it coming through, you do feel some type of kill him. You do feel that.
Likes are just, I mean, when you get a lot of likes, you just feel.
Yeah, it does make you feel better.
I
bump
your head a little.
It does.
I just got 110 likes.
Yeah,
like
it does. It does do it to you.
I see a lot of people on social media, they tend to post pictures of money or like, you know, have a caption like get money this, get money that, and like post pictures of like all the hottest brand names, so like Polo and North Face and whatever the other ones are. I don't really know, but a lot of people tend to do that and try to show through the logo all the time just to prove to everyone that they have money. And it's just like, at the end of the day, regardless if you have money or not, it's not really about that, because at the end of the day, we're all people. So it doesn't really matter how much money you have. You can still be, you can still be like an asshole and have a lot of money. Or some people, like, they'll spend their last paycheck to try to front for social media like they have money and buy all the latest Jordans and stuff like that. But in the long run, they're suffering. Don't know where the next meal is going
to
come from.
You have to be in the right... Oh, and it's about posting it at the right time. If you post it at like 2 a.m., you have to know your followers. If you post it at 2 a.m. and you know your followers are like morning scrollers, then you post at like 2 a.m. so it'll show on their timeline first, so you get more likes that way. And it also depends on the day. But I feel like it's a struggle for likes, because people feel like the more likes you get, the more popular you are.
Or if they're just confident about themselves in general.
They want
likes
or a lot of followers.
Or some people might say, like, Instagram or whatever, it's just another way for people to prove themselves to other people. Yeah. Like, with outfits and how much that outfit costs, and showing the name brands. Make sure that True Religion sign shown on the back of your jeans. Like, in the picture. It's trying to prove yourself to other people.
Yeah. And the likes count, because a lot of people want... You know those people that like five of my pictures for a shout out, or like shout out for shout out. People want shout outs so that they can gain more followers, so that
more
will
people
to gain
see, yeah.
likes.
I feel like if you have to show your skin so much, then you feel like you don't have anything else personally to offer to anybody else. You show more skin so you can get more attention, to get more likes or something like that, or to just look better to the public, because, you know, sex sells, so they say. So maybe that's the reason why people are showing more skin, or guys are putting their pants lower.
I see myself on social media. I feel like, for me, social media is about entertaining, and like, I'm a funny person. I decided to think I am. So, I don't know. It's, for me, it's just like having fun, posting pictures, saying things or something.
I guess some people could possibly see me as conservative. I don't really think that people would see me differently from how I see.
Personally, I will say on social media, I have grown a lot, because in the beginning, I don't want to say I was a follower, but I didn't know how to treat Facebook or MySpace or Twitter and everything. So, like, usually what I've seen other people posting is kind of similar to what I would post. So if people post more about their feelings or more about what they're going through, then I'll feel like, oh, maybe on this social network, that's what I'm supposed to do. But as time progressed, I've noticed that I need to be my own person, and I'm not a very open person when it comes to social media. I shouldn't have to tell people my whole life in order to prove myself. So I only show people what they need to see, which are my accomplishments and things that make me happy.
I think me, like, on social networks, I just like a good selfie. And
she's a lurker.
Or, oh yeah, and I like to be nosy, like, up on other people's posts, like, find stuff out about people's lives, like.
Okay, I think I see myself as pretty straightforward. If I'm either putting up a meme, or me going to a party, or me hanging out with my friends, or a video, something of that sort, it's never usually like, oh hey, here's my legs, or like, you know, when I actually really don't like when, like, somebody's showing too much skin just to say something stupid, like if they have like a tattoo in it, or they say like, oh, my leg hurts, but then you show like yourself with panties and stuff, like that was unnecessary. Or you're like, look it, I've got a new necklace and your whole shirt's off, like it makes no sense. I have not put up a picture with minimal clothing. I mainly put up pictures with clothes. The most I've done is shorts. I'm sure. Got some heels on. I mean, I haven't done the most for likes, you know? I haven't, like, posed on the top of a building just to get the best scenery. People would do it, too. Or I'd put, like, 6 filters on a picture. I've seen it before.
I don't do this because it's not the type of person I am. I don't want to reflect something that I'm not on social media. And if I did post those pictures, it's just kind of me asking for people to like my pictures and like me on social media. And I want people like me in person, not over Facebook or Instagram.
No. I guess I just don't find it necessary to post pictures like that, and I'm not that type of person. And seeing people trying to look like seductive or sexy in pictures or bragging about money is really annoying, and it makes it seem like you're looking for attention.
All my body, like in my room, you know, it'll be an outfit that I'm wearing to the club. It'll be that. That's the outfit. The outfit just happens to be showing me skin. But I'm going out, yeah. But I'm not. But I've never done like. I feel like there's a difference than being in your room, like in the mirror, like
you pull your shirt up on purpose.
Like
I know I fold this one up here. Like your shirt is full length, so why do you need to fold it up and like turn the hat? And
I feel like there's a difference when that's your outfit. That's what you're leaving outside, going outside with. Like people are gonna see you in that, like at the party or whatever. I feel like that's different. But yeah, I've been in minimal clothing on Instagram.
I try hard not to do that because you're basically asking for unwanted attention or maybe wanted attention depending on who you are. And girls are very quick to say, oh, you're thirsty, you're this and you're that. But when you dress like before, I mean, what kind of attention do you think that you're going to get? So I'm not saying that I wear a turtleneck in every single picture. Of course, like I show a little bit of skin here and there. Like if I'm going out, like if I'm wearing a blue dress or something like that, I don't see anything wrong with that. But as far as like being half naked just to get some likes, it's not worth it. So, and then basically that means that the whole world already seen your body, and there's nothing to look for any man to look ever look forward to with life. You know what I mean? Because everybody.
People, it helps you get lighter. Hefe and Valencia and what the hell? Gosh. Dang, I forgot the second one. But those make you look lighter, and then the nice little shade on you makes you like some of them actually get rid of blemishes too. I've seen it. Like if you have a blemish and you put like a light filter.
It all depends on how you're raised and in what situations you are raised in. Guys and girls usually find different things to be significant, and I think culture plays a big part in the things that people appreciate. Class could affect how a person portrays themselves because people of different classes obviously have different things and different opportunities.
I don't think learning it more just has to do with your friends, like your self-confidence. It doesn't matter what race or gender or class you're in. I mean, sometimes I think that, actually, no, it's just different. It just depends on the type of person you are.
People, I don't know, maybe darker people, they want to portray themselves as lighter skin, things like that. And they want, or maybe, no, lighter skin people don't want that. Well, some white people do actually use that by the chance, but as far as dark skin people, they want to be portraying themselves as lighter because they feel like lighter skin people get more attention. And as far
I'm
as
not saying everyone, definitely not everyone, but I noticed that on social media, a lot of people want to be portrayed as or seen as like light, a lighter tone, like light skin or white or something along those lines, because that's what society has instilled in our minds throughout our lives. So because when you're darker skinned or brown or something like that, people, not everyone, but a lot of people like is like, no, I don't want to be dark, I want to be this and that. So I noticed that a lot of light-skinned girls or boys get more attention on social media than darker, and I don't feel like color should define how beautiful or handsome you are, but for some people it does. So
I haven't really seen much, actually, like how people portray themselves on social media. Oh, for class, a lot of people exploit the things that they buy. Like, it's like, oh, you know, just got the new Louboutins, or, you know, I'm in Dubai, or, you know, like, they show a lot of things that they, where they've been, what they're buying, where they're going, why they're, like, it's kind of like pushing it in people's face and stuff, like, or they have, like, a whole row of money laid out on their bed or something, or they're like, it's kind of like being flashy and stuff, so I guess it's a competition in that aspect.
I also see, like I was saying before, a lot of people showing money, showing alcohol, drugs, fancy clothes that they probably can't afford, but like wanting all of those things to prove that there's that their financial status is up there, to prove that they're at the top of the totem pole, to show that they're rich, when they may not be. But in social media is life for a lot of people, so they'll try their best seem rich so everyone can look up to them.
Gender, females are definitely looking for likes. I feel like more than men, because they know that men on Instagram per se are lurkers. So Instagram is basically a nice portal for men to scroll through a female's pictures, and if she's got the most provocative pictures, then he's gonna like it, then maybe she gets a number or he gets a number, and then she finds her dream man.
Gender. What I'll say about gender, I could be wrong, everyone has a different opinion. Women on social media, the women that get more attention on social media are the ones that portray themselves as either like extremely independent and like, you know, goal driven, or the women that are the submissive, sexy, promiscuous kind of women. The promiscuous, sexy ones, I would say, get more attention because a lot of men are on social media and they tend to wanna, you know, look at risque pictures or pictures of girls half naked. So a lot of girls try their best to, you know, poke their butt out or like have a minimum amount of clothes on to get more attention and more likes. A lot of girls wear weave a lot of the times because society has, you know, portrayed that if you don't have like long flowing hair, like your hair is not beautiful and stuff like that, or like big hair and stuff. For men, they try to seem very like strong and confident and independent, so like a lot of men will try to, you know, flex their muscles in the camera and like, you know, try to take pictures where they look just like they're the dopest person around or the flyest person around, whatever you want to call it. So social media has taken over many lives, especially in America.